Sometimes there's nothing to do except just to keep going. And that's pretty much where I'm at right now today. Very, very tough, to say the least. Expect a lot out of today. And so, instead of that, I got a lot of trouble. Maybe that's beneficial, right? But the most bizarre thing happened today. Went into Home Depot. And I was there picking something up, and this person comes in, and what the heck? And he's coming right next to where I was working with the cashier, and he has this large reptile on his shoulder, clinging to his shoulder, and everybody's going, "What the heck is this?" Well, people say, "What is it?" He said, "It's a dragon. It's a dragon. Got a dragon." So really? And so he said, well, he called it a bearded dragon. So it's this large reptile, bearded dragon. And of course everybody's attention is fascinated on that. And he says, "Here, you want to pet it? You know, here, come on, pet the dragon." Not to me, said that, but all the cashiers, the ladies there, were all oohing and awing and asking questions and making a big fuss. "Oh, he's so cute. Oh, he's so nice. Oh." I'm just saying, like, my God, are you kidding me? I don't like reptiles, say the least. And to bring this large reptile into a public store, you know, the guy was so heavy density, it was just appalling. So I got out of there, had to go to the other part of the store, and came back and picked something up, and he was still there, and they were all, you know, still creating such a commotion. Now, The one of the functions of the ladies in society is to put something down they don't like. They say, oh, I'm scared. I don't like this. And that puts the whammy on it, right? The guy's got to deflate him and says, oh, wow. But no, they're doing the opposite. They're like just enthralled. Oh, this is so cool. This is so awesome. Look at this thing. Oh, wow. Oh, what's this? What's the name? Can I pet it? Oh, wow. And it's just like, they didn't ask me if I wanted to, but I said, no, I don't. I mean, let me ask another question. Do I want to pet your reptile now? Do you want to, descend down into heavier density, or do you want to go up to lighter density? I think that's the question, isn't it? But I didn't have the presence of mind. See, the problem is, I can say stuff, but it comes later. I don't have the presence of mind to say stuff when stuff happens. And then another situation, I was berated by a diva who, you know, left the gate open. So the dogs could have gotten out. You know, it's like, can't let the dogs out. They're going to, their lives revolve around their dogs, you know. And so I get berated. Here's someone who's lightening up their density to a great extent, getting berated by a rich diva, you know, low density, you know. But I don't have the presence of mind to respond to it, you know? And it's always been that way here. It seems like that we don't know how to respond. We get taken by surprise. You know, the last thing you think. Stuff is collapsing into heavy density so fast. We don't know how to respond. You're in shock. I can't believe that this is happening. But I'm sick and tired of that, you know. I'm just sick and tired of it. I really got depressed this afternoon. I'm in a completely low density, dead end job. The whole world is collapsing. Now, the worst thing of all, the World Series starts today. In fact, it's going right now, probably about inning number 4 right now, which is about the biggest highlight of my life is to watch the World Series. And because I enjoy it. And I can't watch it because it's too demonic. It's pulling everyone down at a heavy density. All the commercials, all the byplay, the banter, the overall attitude, the complete package. You can't separate stuff out. It's a package. And it's simply too demonic right now. I can't do it. I can't watch the basketball. Basketball season's starting. And again, the overall tenor of television is so heavy density right now. If I watch that, I'm going to fail to get to a lighter density. So I can't do it. So I can't really do anything, it seems like. There's nobody, I don't meet anybody that is aspiring to, lighter density. It's just like a complete lose, 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 lose in every possible way. And I get glimpses of success, and it seems like it's right on the cusp, but it always seems that way because the density keeps getting heavier here. So, what you knew yesterday isn't enough to cover the problems of today. You just, so it shows that I left the reptile guy who was just, wow, piece of work, that's for sure. Piece of work. And I went to the other area of the store, and here's some guy, heavy density guy, dressed in this sort of shiny black kind of outfit. It was just, his whole being was so heavy density, and he had like some nose ring through the center of his nose, like a bull, bull, and just all, saying, "Hey, I'm heavy density and I'm cool." This stuff just gets you so depressed. I'm so sick and tired of it. Everybody's being pulled down. You just see the heaviness. Even this diva, I could see her face was just a mess. She had all this makeup on and so many different eyeliners and makeup on her eyes and stuff, but she's like, super rich person, incredibly wealthy, and yet she's getting pulled down. She's a mess. The whole place is getting pulled down into a heavy, real heavy density. And I can't see anything happening that's helping it. This was so extraordinary. I can see what's possible, but it doesn't happen. I could see with the potential to help out, but it doesn't start, So it's just bizarre, totally bizarre. If there's some great plan to help us out, it certainly, I don't see it. I can see again the potential to lighten up, but does it happen? Not yet. And it's I expected that today was D-Day for me. It's just got to be done today. We don't want to go another day. So maybe it will happen this evening. I don't know. There's no signs of it really. It's hard to say, but today I was saying, look, I'm not the flesh anymore. I'm light. I'm light. I'm light. I identify with light. I don't identify with the flesh or materiality at all anymore. And we just have to keep working at that and keep subjecting ourselves to the influence of lighter, much lighter density. It's just a way of talking, but it's a practical way of speaking because, indeed, you look at people. I mean, this guy with the reptile. My God, he was heavy set. He just felt dense, and just his whole demeanor was something to just say, yuck, I want to stay away from this. The way he talked, and he was just like symbiotically linked with the reptilian consciousness, very heavily. God knows what tattoos he had just all over, and just, and this reptile's got these red eyes, and it's just like blinking at me, looking at me, blank, blank, blank. Poor creature, probably wondering what the heck is going on. This maniac is taking me all over the place, but it's a way of linking with, reptilian Draco, reptilian consciousness, which is heavy, heavy density. And the movies, the commercials, the pop culture, people's attitudes have just been pulled down to just extremely depressing extent, I don't know how they all, don't commit suicide, so they do, but somehow they seem to like it. Maybe it's continuity fear. It protects them from continuity fear, that, oh gee, or they're so afraid to lighten up that this is a way of protecting themselves. But for those of us who are not afraid of lightening up, it's hell here. Absolutely hell. Uh, And so, at some point you have to either fish or cut bait, and at some point you got to fish, you got to. And so didn't get it last night. Hopefully tonight, but I can't really count upon it. It doesn't seem we can really count upon any sort of timetable to ultimate for our own. I can see the timetable of the world, and that's been accurate. But as far as our own salvation from it, I can't discern a definite timetable as far as progress goes. It's hard to say, difficult to say what to do. We can complain about it. At least here we can complain about it and point out there's a problem here. But this society, this culture is no bueno anymore. It's no good. It's way, way, way too heavy density. And in that condition, they want to lose sight of salvation. That's their goal. Because they think if they lose sight of salvation, the continuity fear will abate. Guess what? It only temporarily abates. And then it flares up again even worse because they find out that they don't like this heavy density. And so the choice is go even heavier or start lightening up. And then they start lightening up, and then the continuity fear jumps up and bites you. So this is a fool's paradise here right now. Very bad fool's paradise. And I saw how I've been tricked my whole life. As soon as you come in this world to help, there's all these manipulators that say, "Oh, help, 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 I'm in trouble. People are chasing after me, they're trying to get me." Why? Because they've scammed them, because they've taken advantage, and they say, "Oh, help, help, help," and then you're supposed to help them. If you don't, then you're nothing. You're terrible. It's I don't know how anyone comes in this world and witnesses the truth. It's I'm not sure what the key of it all is. I have ideas, and they surface, and I say, maybe that's it. You need to just be some extraordinary clarity, not to get trapped here by the flesh, by those who are, everybody. There's a lot of people who have people after them. Because it's dog eat dog here, and they have a lot of enemies, and they expect your job is to just get in the way of their enemies, basically. So they attack you instead of them. That's really how they see help here. I mean, if you had somebody stalking you, after you, trying to attack you and kill you, and you see someone that you think, "Oh, there's a nice person. Here, let me put them in between me and the attacker," If they're and say, "Hey, you're a good person, we want to do a good deed," okay, here's a good deed you can do. Get in between. I mean, that just this is the way the world is. It's hard to blame them, right? I mean, if we were in their shoes, we'd probably think the same way. Yeah, you want to help me? Great. There's someone after me. Why don't I direct them over your way, and they can attack you instead of me, and then I can be relieved. And say, "Oh, good. Now I can and then I can practice spirituality, but I can't practice now because somebody's after me." This is the trouble in the world. I mean, this issue has to be addressed because this is a fact. This is a fact. I mean, book spirituality only goes so far. There's a pragmaticness to all of this. And the fact is that there's just this nasty dynamic in the world here of people burning other people, and everybody is can be quite agitated. There's all sorts of enemies. People are scared, they're hiding out, they're looking for somebody to take the brunt of the trouble on their shoulders, even though they hadn't played no role in generating in the first place. And then this they claim is good. This is righteousness. This is God helping them. They say, "Oh, you're from God? Oh, great. Then you're here to help me then. Okay, so you take the brunt of the trouble." This sort of thing. This has got nothing to do with it. And so, I just have to, I'm trying to see through this, and I'm, almost there, but almost is, no good at all here. This is the trouble. Almost is no good at all. I had a bill. Someone had something repaired, and it was a super high bill. I said, "Wow, I could have like bought a new some I could have bought a new tool for the price of repairing this one, brand new." But the owner went to bat for me and lessened the bill. I told him, I don't want to, if it costs too much, don't repair it. So he cut it in half, more than in half for me. Interesting. So someone lightened my load without, with me not even asking them, really. But we wonder if that, you know, if there's, maybe that's an example of grace, is, you know, going to lighter density instead of this heavier density. Someone's trying to lay a heavy density upon me, and I get help, and the grace of God helps, and go to a lighter density. And so if these people want protection, you know, they have to work on the spiritual path and lessen their continuity fear. You know, if they say that heavy density is, you know, they're trying to make heavy density satisfactory to them, it doesn't work. And they, but they're too scared to go to lighter density. I mean, I expect you to come down here and help out by taking, you know, that's not right. You know, Holy Spirit has to address this. This is the fundamental problem here. Is everybody screaming for help because they're trying to get satisfaction through dominating other personalities, and the other personalities fight back, and you know they just think that they need help to protection. You know, how many, the rich people, how many people have they stepped on and crushed? A lot of times, so many, 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 the people, successful people. Successful people are usually the ones who want protection the most. And they'll pay you anything. I'll pay you. Don't worry. I'll pay you. Pay you. Pay you. Well, I don't want to be involved in that. I don't care. There's not enough money in the universe to pay me. And then they'll say, well, then you're no teacher at all. The teaching is continuity fear. And they're completely overlooking that, because the ego completely overlooks continuity fear. Without this teaching, then I don't see how it's possible for anybody to get anywhere here. With this teaching, you have a road, you know, you have a way. You have a focus. You can say, oh, I'm suffering because of continuity fear. And for no other reason, actually. So I've had my most success in focusing on this issue of continuity fear. But I would say again, you know, where the rubber meets the road is when you can't, for me, I can't even watch the World Series. I say, I just can't do it. I thought I'd make an exception, say, oh yeah, you know. And it's a funny thing, everybody I talked to today about the World Series, they all look at me like, what? World Series? No, I'm not going to watch that. So maybe they're sending me a message, you know, don't watch it. It's just, the price is too steep now. The price that we're paying here for this whatever crumbs we can get here is now prohibitively heavy. And again, heavy density is hiding from God, is all that it is. And I don't need to hide from God anymore. So what do I need heavy density for? You know, it doesn't serve any purpose. And so people just assume I'm here to, you know, run in and protect them, run interference for them or something. This is crazy. I know I'm here to get out of here, you know, is what I'm here for. I mean, and you know, the Holy Spirit knows about the continuity fear, so the Holy Spirit, let the Holy Spirit take care of others. So, you know, if they don't want to listen, they say, well, got to wait for me. Well, it could be a long wait. I don't see any sign of them trying at all to rehab. So I don't have time to hang around and wait. This is go time right now. And those who, nobody else is going, so they say, well, you don't have a right to go either. If we don't go, you can't go. Well, that's nonsense. We're all free, you know. We're free. I'm sovereign authority. I'm total authority. I am the total authority over my experiencing. That is true. Each one of us is. They're just choosing to hide from God, and they want help because they're afraid people are after them. They say, well, how can I stay here if people are after me? So you got to make it seem nicer here for me. No, I don't have to. I don't have to help people hide from God. That's their problem. And Of course, they say, oh, if you don't help me, I'll never trust the Holy Spirit. Well, I have to put that in the Holy Spirit's hands. I say, Holy Spirit's your problem. They say they'll never trust you, but hey, you know, that's not my problem. And I know the Holy Spirit will find a way. So I think this is maybe the crux of the whole. I saw this, I think, yesterday or day before, is that we're being blackmailed here, plain and simple. They say, if you don't do what we tell you to do, we'll never trust the Holy Spirit. And I say, fine. You know, what I said was, okay, fine. Go ahead and never trust the Holy Spirit. See how that works out for you. And the Holy Spirit always has a way. In fact, has already saved everyone. So what they're saying is nothing but a bluff. Absolute bluff. There's nothing else other than that. So October 27th here, and this is, you know, just what I experienced today. It just hit home. How terrible it is. And those women, you know, and before, 50 years ago, that guy could never have walked in the store with a reptile. And the women would have screamed and gone hysterical. And the security would come running and says, sir, you can't bring that in here. We have policy of whatever. It's just that you're upsetting people too much. We ask you to leave. I mean, society would have backed them up 100%. So women really control society through their reactions. I couldn't say anything to the guy. I said, hey, I don't like reptile, get out of here. He said, hey, who are you? You know, you want to fight? You look like you're trying to pick a fight with me. But if the women would have gone hysterical, you know, nothing he could have done. So they do control, you know, control culture, society. Women absolutely do. And by inviting this guy in and giving all this attention and saying how awesomely cool it is, and, you know, oh, they're just swooning, you know, over this. Although one of them, I think, was faking it. They were faking it. But that just shows you how the culture, expectations of the culture are so strong now. Someone walks in with some hideous-looking reptile that you're supposed to think, oh, this is the most wonderful thing, and act that way. But one of them kept looking at me like, because I wasn't responding. And she said, oh, that's so cool. And then kind of look at me like, kind of her eyes kind of like, oh, like, wow, this freaks me. And she did say a couple things like, oh, is this the one that attaches itself to you and won't let go? Stuff like that. So, you know, she may have been a Christian. It may have been freaking her out. Maybe she didn't like it, but she felt the peer pressure was so strong. She went along with it. This is what's happening. And I think this is what is catastrophic right now. This is my feeling. I didn't say anything to her. You know, I should have said something, but the guy was still there. But as I was leaving, she kind of looked at me and kind of went like, you know, wow. This, I don't like this, but I can't say anything. This is my intuition about it. And so this means that those who hate heavy density feel that they can't resist it. They can't say anything. That, you know, they've been overwhelmed, and this you know, heavy density guy, very heavy density, dark heavy density, feeling that he can troll around with you know, reptiles draped over him and think that this is, you know, the coolest thing ever. You know, he feels he can do that. Nobody's going to say a word. I mean, next thing you know, they'll bring him into church. They'll be coming to church with, you know, with these hideous snakes wrapped around their heads and necks. You see people going around with snakes too. I mean, it's and no one says a word. I'll sit back. They say, oh, it's so awesome. Look how beautiful the skin is. Oh, he's so cute. What does he do? Does he eat? Does he bite? Does he eat you? Does he bite? You know, oh, no. He said, oh, no, he's so sweet. Or she, I don't know. They're so sweet. Such a loving creature, you know. So I just watched this scenario. You know, I think this Holy Spirit just was showing me how far it's collapsed now. That even Christian women, even religious women, even women who want to have a lighter density, feel that they can't even do what's their role in society is to act up when they don't like something. Because that saves a fight from the man. They'll go to the man and say, hey, get rid of this guy, because then there's going to be a fight. You know, it's the role of the women to act up as only they can do. You know, get hysterical, which they're so expert at. And just scream, ah! You know, what's happening to women? Upset to scream, you know, ah! And you know, oh, my blood pressure. Oh my God, I just feel terrible. Oh, come and call an ambulance. This reptile so scared me so bad. I'm allergic to them. I have a phobia of them. Oh, they're expert actresses. They can act hysterical easily. They certainly do when they don't something they don't like. But now they're not. They didn't say a word. Just the opposite. They're just gushing, absolutely gushing. Oh, and so this guy thinks, hey, this is what women like. So they're encouraging him. They're encouraging this sort of behavior. And see, there's no way to get around that, you know? There's a fact. They're encouraging this behavior. They're encouraging heavy density. But I think there was one of them there, maybe more. I don't know how many were just going along with what they thought they needed to go along with, who seemed like she was uncomfortable with it, but was acting the opposite way. I bet there are many, many, you call it the silent majority, who are very uncomfortable with what's happening here. And yet they feel that they cannot speak up against it. They're trapped, you see? So I'm trying to speak up again, but nothing, there's no movement. I haven't been able to move the needle at all, which is just terrifying. I thought, hey, at least if I speak up, maybe there'll be a movement. We'll have to start, move the needle, and people start saying, hey, maybe we can speak up. Let's start speaking up. But if the women don't act out, act up, then nothing the men can do. This is a fact on this planet. And if they say, oh, no, it's perfectly okay with me. In fact, we like it. Who are you to say? What can a man say? You can't say anything. You could rebuke them, but they'll still encourage the other men, and then they'll actually start a fight between the two of you. Such is the power of women here in this world. And they claim they don't have power. This is ridiculous. They're just using it in a way that they feel guilty about. So, women's liberation means let's go to heavier density, folks. Here we go. And if you say no, they say, oh, you're, and they start labeling, calling you names, acting out, being hysterical, being upset with you, because that we want why we want heavier density. Why? Because they're continuity fear. They're not working on it. They're not rehabbing. They're too busy, trying to cater to the body. Maybe I'm not feeling so great today because all I had this morning was a kale smoothie. That's all I've had to eat all day. It's late now. What is it? That was like 12 hours ago. Kale, just about 12 hours ago. Kale smoothie. Say, gosh, life isn't so good, is it? I mean, the one thing we can do in this world is eat good food, right? If you can afford, most of us can at least, eat something. I mean, go cook some spaghetti, for God's sakes, and put some ketchup on it and some Parmesan cheese, and at least it tastes, something. Or go get some ice cream. I mean, yeah, got $5, go down and buy a quart of ice cream and eat that and put some fudge sauce on it and nuts and call it good. So at least eating like that gives you some feeling that there's some, fairy dust in this place that at least it's not so hideous. But if you can't even do that, or you can't even watch the World Series or eat ice cream. I mean, last World Series, I had a party and we had every kind of indulgent food possible there, I'm telling you. We went all in. That's when I started went off the wagon and started overeating. We just had every kind of chips and nuts and drinks, soft drinks and all fruit, all sorts of drinks of every kind. Oh, so many potato chips and dips and you name it. I mean, we just had a huge spread of everything you can think of. Popcorn, hot dog, the whole schmear. It was just intense. And had some people over, and but they only came over one day, and I was stuck with all the rest of the food, so I ended up eating it over the whole World Series, and that's when I started gaining weight. So it's been a year of indulging in food, but it was a fun year. At least I felt like, hey, if I want to eat some popcorn, I can eat some popcorn. Drink some lemonade, I'll drink some lemonade. Take that away, take food away. Then the world becomes a very raw place, and you get depressed because there is no saving grace in this world whatsoever. Really, there's no redeeming aspect of this world whatsoever. Actually, if you look at it honestly, not a shred of this world has a redeeming any redeeming value for us. So why even, then you say, why even pay attention to it? I should just die. Well, we hope there's a vision that will come that will show us, lighter density. It's the only hope we have. If that doesn't come, we don't have any hope here, actually, other than stuffing our faces. Sex, drugs, rock and roll, you can add food to that. That somehow we just have to try to make it seem like it's not as bad as it really is. That's why people drink, isn't it? I remember someone quite famous, said, I don't drink to, what is it? To be more interesting. People think that people drink so they're more interesting to, He says, no, I drink so because it makes other people seem more interesting to me. You see, because it really, really nobody's interesting. And we get so depressed if they drink. Everybody else seems interesting. Hey, how you doing? So it seems like the drunks are gregarious, but they're not because they are more think themselves are more interesting. It's that the other people seem more interesting to them. But it's a mirage, it's an illusion. And then they wake up in the morning with a hangover, and the world's hideous, and they have to drink more. They say, "Oh God, I can't take this anymore." So we get upset with spiritual teachers, Holy Spirit, and all that because we want more results, faster results, and we're not getting them. We haven't got them. So what could we do? We're a captive audience. We're stuck. But wow, expect better results, quicker results, because the world really is in terrible shape, and still we're just floundering here. There's been a ton of progress, but again, close isn't good enough here. It's like I almost have dropped the world, but not yet, and so there's still some way to hook me into it. What good is that? That's no good at all. And it just Jesus says we have to track down every resistance, every exception. Well, that could take a long time. It has taken a long time. And for me, there should be just one response to this world, just one response to every situation. Why do we keep coming up with different responses where it's all the same? Really, it's all the same situation, just repeating itself endlessly. Why should I? Why can't we just have one response? Call it good. Why do I? I keep thinking, well, how do I respond to this? And how I what? Why? Why do I have to come up with that? It should just be, hey, one to say one thing, and that's it, because that's the world is completely flat. That just say, look, it's all flat. Everything here is going. I see the world's totally flat. So that's my response. It's totally flat. Has no value for me. Maybe we should just say, look, I see the world is totally flat. Doesn't have any value for me, and now I'm experiencing the space, pure spaciousness. Instead of trying to see pure spaciousness in a total flatness where it can't be, well, ultimately, it's there also, it's everywhere. But from the pragmatic, intermediate step, we recognize that the illusion of spaciousness is being contained somehow, is false. It's a false illusion. So flatten the illusion out. We're trying to contain spaciousness. This is the illusion. So we just say, hey, you cannot contain spaciousness at all. This world's just flat. That's how I see everything. It's just flat. So that's my response to whatever you say. People will say, well, you're crazy. Well, maybe it's a good crazy, right? We cannot keep responding to people as if, there's some legitimacy to this mirage. I thought I saw a big mosquito there. That's not good. So a lot of situations arose today, and but at some point you have to draw a line, right? And so I said, I just have to draw a line here with popular culture now. I just can't. I watched MLB channel last night, and the commercials are just too. I could not. I say I cannot do this anymore. It's too. They're too wicked. They're just pulling out all the stops to drag us down into this deep, dark density. I've had enough. I've had enough of that. I have to play the games without me. So I'm trying to lighten up. Everything I do, I'm trying to lighten up. But the videos I do, the slide videos I do, it's all designed to try to lighten this up in this super, super heavy time now that we're in. I think people are so heavy right now that nothing lightens them up. This is how I read it. You know, I think they just say, "What's the use?" You know, we're sunk. Well, I don't feel sunk. I'm pretty upset, but I got to hang in there. But we need, you know, quick action response now. No more of this. Eventually. Eventually is now. I've done enough work for me. Eventually is now. And of course, sour grapes, if you're not going down to darker density, the thing is they don't want, they think that they're trying to hide from God, as if they haven't, you know, that none of this is they haven't imagined any of this, trying to deceive God. So they don't want anyone lightening up, because God will say, "Hey, you see, such and such did it, you can do it too. The grace is there to do it." And they say, no, God, there's no grace there. It's impossible to do. So they're all against you. You know, they're all against, this is, the world is against those who want lighter density. It's not for them at all. At least their continuity fears is very much against it. They're afraid that it's because they want a default. They say there is no path. There is no path. I mean, there is no way, there is no grace, there is no way. We're stuck here, you know, we can't leave here. This is what they want to say, we can't leave here, it's impossible. This is the reality, heavy density is reality, there is no other reality. There is no grace, there is no continuity fear. This is just natural, this is just a natural, normal way that we are. This is what they want to attest and affirm to. So if you're, you know, some light density being, they say, "Go, you know, you get out of here. You're a freak. You're scaring me." And they go hysterical on that. I think the women will probably start going hysterical in that way, which then makes it virtually impossible to function here. Because everybody, you know, is a dupe for a hysterical woman. "Oh, what's the matter?" Of course they, you know, palpitations. "I have heart palpitations. I have a fit of the vapors. My blood pressure is sore." Of course, they can make their blood pressure sore, get heart palpitations, pass out. You know, "Give me water. I think I'm dying." You know, they're experts at that. This is part of the shtick that controls the situation here. You know, what do you say to that? I mean, the Holy Spirit has to have some response to that, because this is the reality of the situation here. And if there's no response to that, then how do you get free of it? You know, how do you function here as a lighter density being? And all the gentlemen rush in to help the hysterical lady. "Oh my gosh, what disturbed you? You know, oh, my baby, I think that's going to cause a still, you know, cause a miscarriage, you know. Oh, no." It's like, "Oh, get away. You're disturbing her." Well, you know, it's probably some spirit wants to come into the world. Some demonic spirit wants to come in the world. And the demonic spirit that's identifying with the child, the baby within them, is saying, "I don't want to come in a world with those light beings here. You know, I'm terrified. And the woman will start reacting, you know, to her child, speaking to her, as it were. You know, like that. And so this is how it is now. The demonic beings love to come into this world now. And by that I mean those who have severe continuity fear, who want heavier density. This is what it really means, demonic being. They want real heavy density, real dark. So they think that God can't see them. You know, they think it's safe. They live in a hideous place. They say, well, God will never see me here, never suspect, you know, what's going on. Can't find me here. Never expect that this is just, that spirit is pretending to be this. Oh, God must be somewhere else. Trying to hunt spirit down. God's not trying to hunt spirit down. Spirit, God knows where spirit is. It's reality. So, it's a funny thing. As people, you know, dive into dark density, heavy density, at first they think that's safety. And then later on they say, well, wait, well, this is kind of scary for me. I don't like this. But they don't recognize that they're only going, you know, hiding from themselves, really. And people are getting sick right now. There's no question about it. I'm getting depressed. I'm getting jittery. I'm getting nervous. I'm able to keep it at that by tremendous effort. But it is a fact that the strain now is affecting people's health. And the people I know, you know, and they're severely struggling. They don't have the answers, you know. The world's going to hell, as they put it. It's going to hell in a handbasket, which means going into heavier density. Interesting, that dream I had of this mountain, a real heavy, dense mountain. And we were living right next to it, but it was really flat, beautiful area. And there was no density there. The mountain represents density, very, very dense heaviness. But we're living real close to it, meaning we haven't really gotten far away from our continuity fear yet. And we're still saying, well, I want to be close to, I don't want the density, but I want to be close to it. This is like what this world has been like for a while. But now, the density is going to collapse on top of us. This is what I saw in the dream, and bury us in this heavier density. So I had to get away from that heavy mountain. So our fears and all our projections, everything are built up like a big mountain, and we're trying to stay away from it that way. But that's the personality. That doesn't work. The chickens come home to roost. This is what's happening in the world now. Man, I'm not watching the news. I'm not even watching sporting events right now. Catch it. Go to the Weather Channel, and sometimes they have a sidebar that has a few things, that a couple of headlines are local, but it's always terrible stuff, you know, local stuff. It's always violent, terrible, violent stuff. You know, it's just crazy. This is how to go into deeper, darker density. The internet is just a sewer. You know, society is a sewer right now. And we're all sewer rats, you know, living here. Like, so I don't want to be a sewer rat. That's what we're turning into if we don't get help. And I don't know, where's the help? So far, it hasn't shown up. Maybe it will, starting tomorrow. Some will say there's a separation of the densities. Density's going to take place here. Well, I hope so. It hasn't happened yet. They've been saying that for a long time. You know, the thing about the spiritual, so-called spiritual people is they keep saying something great's going to happen, and they keep kicking the can down the road, and it doesn't happen. And, you know, at some point you say, wow, what's going on here? I'm a little more pragmatic than that. I say we have to work at it, and don't leave it to some prophecy or something. We hope, but, you know, also hope for the best, prepare for the worst. And so we need to be liberated ourselves, rather than rely on some great teacher coming in the world or something. If they do, that's great. But if they don't, we better liberate ourselves, which is to call our own projections home. This is how we are liberated, actually. No more projection. I am light. You see, I'm light. I'm the only authority there is. I'm light. That's all that I am. And this is what I feel. I feel as though I feel very light, as if I were light. This is what we have to go towards. We have to actually feel it. So this is where I'm at now, is just feel light, like overall lightness. I'm not flesh, I'm light. I'm not flesh, I am light. I am not flesh, I am light. And just start experiencing ourselves as light. This is what we have to do, really. The rhetoric is great, it's helpful, we've done that. Now it's time to experience ourselves as light, plain and simple. But there again, other people will like maybe start shrieking, says, what the heck, you know. So I don't know how to deal with that. We'll have to find out. We have to get answers here. So we just have to find answers, that's all. It's a little frustrating, you have to keep working hard. You ask the Holy Spirit what to do, the Holy Spirit says, work harder. And I said, good Lord, I've been working my entire life, working myself to death. Now I have to work harder, so, yeah, I guess so. Maybe not for long, though. Maybe, we need to make a little burst here, which is, I'm fine with that. I'll keep trying. I should be reading Course in Miracles lessons in the morning and the evening. I want to do that. I just can't seem to get myself to do it. And I just have to sort of, start doing that. Just go through all the lessons quickly and just refresh the mind, It's all right there if we would just focus on it. I'm just trying to find a quick way to do that. Just to put the lessons, boom, 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 boom. I think I know a way. I'll try, one after another. Starting to rain. It's supposed to rain tomorrow here. So, from my standpoint, the heavy densityness, this collapse is happening right now. And it will lead to people getting desperate, trying to lighten up through drugs. There'll be a drug epidemic. The whole thing is happening now. As of today, it's happening. And it's that reptile situation that just got me like, wow, this is too much. I can't even say anything to this guy. The women won't say anything to him. Well, where does that leave us? I can say something here, but not publicly. If you can't say anything publicly, where does that leave us? It leaves us trapped, like rats in a sewer. This is terrible. I should just be able to say something, and the people will side with you and say, yeah, we're with him, and this guy will then feel, isolated. Say, hey, if you want to be isolated with your reptile, go ahead, but you're not going to bring that into our culture. I don't have any. I don't have hatred. I just don't. I don't want low density. It's plain and simple. It's just preference. We have a right to have for preferences. Guess what? We have a right for preferences. It's not discrimination. It's preference. I don't want to be dragged down into a gangster culture, reptilian gangster culture. I prefer not to. I prefer to go to lighter density. So guess what? We have a right to have preferences. And they keep trying to say we don't. With that, it's that then they sling a bunch of slanderous labels upon us that to be. Just like those who want heavy density have a right to that, have a preference for that. They have a right to have a preference for heavy density and try to hide from God. They have a right. We have a right for lighter density and not to try and hide from God. But their fear makes them feel they have to control everyone because they, again, they don't want God, they don't want any examples of success because they think God will say, hey, look, it does work. So it means it will work for you too. They want to say, no, 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 it doesn't work for anybody. God, you're lying to us. You're deceiving us. We can't be helped. This is what they want to say. So it's not an equal playing field at all. It's a totally uneven playing field because those who want to lighten up are seen as bad in the bad by those who don't. Whereas those who want to get heavier, we don't see them as bad. We just say, hey, I don't want to do that. It's your preference. That's fine. So it's fair. We're fair, but they're not fair. So that's an uneven playing field. This is what really bothers me. I don't see how it's fair at all here for us. They're not going to say, oh, wonderful. You want to be, you know, go to lighter density and resolve the continuity fear and go back, you know, realize that, you know, that you're already home, non-dual realization. Oh, great, 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 great. We're all for that. You never hear them say that. They want to say, God, what God? There's no God. There's no grace. There's no Holy Spirit. There's no redemption. There's no salvation. This is real. Nobody can escape. That's what they want to say. They want to say, hey, you can't escape. It's impossible. So how is that a fair playing, fair game? It's not a fair game. It's intrinsically unfair. And again, when you say, I'm going to do it anyway, they say, well, then I'm never going to listen to you or any teacher, the Holy Spirit, or use of grace. I'm going to always completely refuse, which then scares us. They say, oh, no, that's not fair to you. Oh, no, I've called their bluff. I said, go ahead. Let's see. You'll challenge the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit loves that. Tell the Holy Spirit that the Holy Spirit's a complete failure and can never help you. And we'll see what happens. We'll see what happens. We'll see who wins that game. We'll see who wins that bluff. Try to bluff the Holy Spirit. Can't bluff me. Go ahead and try and bluff the Holy Spirit. Because that's what they're trying to do. Using us as you're the reason why we can't be saved because you didn't do what we wanted to do. Well, what they want us to do is deny that salvation is possible. So how can we be the reason that they're not saved? That's completely contradictory. They're claiming there is no salvation, and yet they're also claiming that we have to refuse salvation so they can not be saved. This is nuts. Clearly, they do believe there is salvation, and they're just afraid of it. And so then they try to get heavy on us and say, well, you know, we'll reject God forever, and you're the reason why we did it. And I say, well, go ahead. Yeah, tell the Holy Spirit to be angry at me, or whatever. You can tell the Holy Spirit whatever you want. Doesn't bother me. Tell the Holy Spirit you'll never listen to it. You know, guess what? Short time from now, they'll sing a different tune. And when the heaviness gets to be nasty, they'll say, wow, this is terrible. Help, 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 help. So, you know, so, yeah, threaten all you want. But we have to get to this attitude, you know, because they're very threatening, though, now. They're in full threat mode. And it's astonishing, you know, but it's hard to swallow this, that we can be this frightened, but this is what happens. This is what happens here. But, of course, they say, well, you're dooming me for eternity of suffering. Well, I'm not responsible for your enlightenment. The Holy Spirit is. So, you know, take it up with them. Take it up with the Holy Spirit. I don't have anything to do with it. Other than, you know, the Holy Spirit can point out as something encouraging here, if it wants to. If it doesn't want to, then it doesn't have to. But the Holy Spirit can get past any and all defenses. So they're defenseless against the Holy Spirit. They can brag all they want about how they're going to reject it forever. Doesn't bother the Holy Spirit in the slightest bit. Holy Spirit just smiles and says, I already saved them. I already worked through everything in their case, and they're already saved. Don't worry about it. So, and threaten all they want. I could have said, nah, You want to hold a reptile or the bearded dragon? I said, no, I got the Holy Spirit out here on my shoulder already. There's no room for it. I said, I don't see anything. He says, well, you got to open your eye. You got to have spiritual vision to see it. Yeah, maybe if people offend people. People are so offended now. If you try to lighten up your density, they're so offended. Well, let them be offended then. Take offense at the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit's to blame. It's the Holy Spirit that's lighting me up. So take offense, fine. We have to get to this point. And they will say, they'll threaten the Holy Spirit. Say, we'll never listen to you. If you liberate this one, we'll never listen to you, Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit says, we'll see how that goes. You'll be listening to me in a couple of weeks' time. That's for sure. Singing a different tune. Well, great. Here comes some rain. Just in time for Halloween. It always rains before Halloween. Same old, same old. But once Halloween comes, everything changes really here. That it kicks off kind of the fall going in towards the winter. The leaves start decaying, they're wet, everything starts looking like autumn once the first rain comes. So all this fear leads us into heavier density. It makes us contract, doesn't it? I'm tired of this. Don't want this anymore. I'm tired of this stuff. And the news, again, the news. And not just news, it's just on every internet page I go to, down at the side, right side, usually on the bottom, if you read the story, and on top also, they frame, they encase every story, even if it's about the weather. Well, it's going to be a real nice day today. And they have all these stories, pictures and stuff, and they're all fear-based. Every single one is fear-based. Well, they maybe throw in like something cute occasionally just to say, oh, look, such and such attack, hideous attack, some grotesque thing. You can't believe how macabre it was, this such and such and such, divorce or, this baby, something happened to this. It just as gross as possible. And they just hit you with this every web page. There should be something. I know there's something where you can disable pictures, but still, the content is just hideous what they do. Any story, every website I go to, I just click on a story at United Nations Global Climate, Climate Warming Conference. It's encased with all these hideous content. It's like everybody's wearing a death mask, Here. This is an abomination. It never would have allowed this kind of thing in previous times and cultures. There's some cultures that would absolutely mitigate against this. First of all, you can't use humans in advertising, images in advertising. That's a no-brainer. Cuts it way down right there. The attractiveness of it, but you cannot report all this gory crime stuff. There used to be decency societies here, and the church used to stand for something. And now they're just collapsed. They don't can't say anything about it at all. They do say homilies and say, isn't it awful? But they try to raise their voice, and people just scoff at them and laugh at them. Say, you're losers. Guess what? You're the loser. Shut up. So these demons again are coming in. This world has become demonically possessed, extraordinarily so. I did come across some blurb somewhere, probably on the Weather Channel, I don't know how, and then it was mentioned also here on a comment here about the, in Israel, the people are being taught to stab, and they're teaching children to stab, videos, stabbing videos, and people are, this is just insane, okay? And this is to pull us into lower density. There's ISIS pulling us into lower density. Okay, all of this stuff. They're just a puppet, really, of this agenda, end time agenda to pull us in lower density, is to say, is to default, try to default on our reality. Say we can't go back. How can we go back? Look, we're these monsters. We don't fit in it when reality. We're these heavy Tyrannosaurus Rexes, you know. How can we fit in formless, beautiful, glorious reality? It's impossible. There, how could there be any way to get back there? It's impossible. This is what they're trying to do. Say it's impossible. So who wants to hang around a place where the whole thing's dedicated to saying it's impossible to leave here, you know, this heavy density? Who wants to hang around there when you know it's all fake, it's false? There's no point to it. And they keep saying, well, help, help, help. No, that's just entrapment. That's just an entrapment strategy. Help, help, oh. This, you know, like I have never had that dream where this ingenue was screaming, oh, being tortured so hideously. And I've had someone mention that today to me. This is amazing. That lady that was held captive, kidnapped, held captive for 18 years, what's Dugard or something or whatever. Someone brought that up. Said, wasn't that awful? Isn't that terrible? He said, oh, that was just in conversation. That was what they wanted to converse about. And I just said, well, you know what? Probably she's better off for it. Made her a stronger person. If it doesn't kill you, it makes you stronger. And you know, you got no choice but to toughen up under those circumstances. And they actually agree with me. I think they're very shocked that I said that. Because they're thinking, oh yeah, isn't it awful, the poor lady. Well, the fact is, nothing we're sovereign over our own experiencing. Nothing can happen to us other than we insist that it happens to us. So she insisted that happen. That would be her experience. But it could have been, I believe, that she's better for it. She toughened up. Somehow she really overcame, you know, probably some heavy stuff from that. So we go through tough, we choose tough situations, and we don't like them, and we realize, wow, I don't like this. Wow, you know, how can I not choose this again? And so in that way, we were able to work through a lot of different complexes. So someone did bring up that hideous thing that you know, this is just example of fear and this awful. We're trapped. We can't get free, like this lady. Being a young girl, ingenue, being kidnapped and held by some maniac, you know, for 18 years. This is like just a symbol of this world, isn't it? Like we've been kidnapped. And but then I just responded. I refused to buy into that. I said no. I didn't say directly what I would say to you in the video because they would have been too shocked. But I did make it clear. I said, well, you know what? It's probably for the best. I mean, she probably came out a much stronger person through all of these trials, and I said it in a nice way, and they kind of ended up agreeing with me, but I think they were quite shocked to hear that. They didn't expect to hear that at all. So this is the world. They expect you to go along with their thing, like the whole idiot awful. We're all victimized. We're all victims. There's a planet victimization here. When I say there's no victimization, doesn't exist. Doesn't exist. Even ISIS is not victimizing anyone. Is not. See, people think, oh, it's the perfect victimization scenario. That's why they want it. They want the situation that convinces everybody that victimization is real. Oh, the terrible Christians, ISIS is cutting off their heads and all that stuff. No, nothing is being victimized. They're choosing themselves to experience this sort of experience. To try and convince themselves and others. By convincing others, they hope to convince themselves, actually, that they are trapped, you know, that there is no salvation, that victimization is truth, and that they're not light, they're the bodies. No, I am light, I am free, I'm still exactly as God created me. I'm not a body, I'm free, I'm light. I'm light, exactly as God created me. I am the sole authority, I am total authority, there is no other authority. I am the one authority, there is no other authority. I am total authority, I am light. This is a fact, and those who are pretending otherwise are doing so just again. They're trying to run a scam on God, plain and simple. So there's no victimization taking place, but there is this intense dance of continuity fear that they're acting out this dance. Takes two to dance, two to tango, trying to convince the world of victimization, and people are falling for it. That's what ISIS is really doing. That's all they're doing, all this stuff. That's all they're doing. They're just dancing this dance, trying, you know, part of trying to convince the world And the victims are the ones who are trying to convince more than anybody, so-called, quote-unquote, victims. They're saying, because we try to convince ourselves by convincing others. So they say, oh, look, if everybody sees me get this head cut off, they'll think that I really was a body and I was victimized. And then if they believe that, that'll help me believe that. And we all can believe it together, and so nobody will ever escape, you know, back to reality. And we can then default and say, guess what, God, we changed what you created. It's no longer what you used to do. We're these heavy, dense bodies, and you just, sorry, we have stronger will than you. We changed what we are. This is what they're trying to do. This is what victims try to do. They're trying to change other people. They're trying to get others to believe in their victimization. It's plain and simple. So I just feel like no victimization for me, you know. But that seems like, you know, it's very taboo here. Nobody does it. But I'm at the point, say, I just say, I'm not victimized by anything. Nothing touches me. Nothing touches me. It's impossible. Victimization, I choose not to be victimized in the slightest way. Not even a wrinkle. Everything's immaculate for me. Perfect. And this is the truth. We choose our experiencing. And any experiencing that's designed to make us victims is trying to say that we can change what God created perfect. Because God created us perfectly free. How can we be victimized? It's impossible. Totally impossible. So you see, you don't hear anyone talking this way. And this is a problem. And you have just this constant barrage from the news, media. Fear, 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 victimization. It's just nonstop talk about victimization. Trying to convince everyone's trying to convince everyone else that they're a victim, so they can believe that they can't be saved, which makes their continuity fear. They think it'll make it get less. So we're all tortured by continuity fear. The only difference with me is I found out a way to evaporate it, thanks to, you know, the great teachers. You know, I've named them off: Buddha, Jesus Christ, Adi Shankara, Longchenpa, Rama Maharshi, and Anandamayi Maha, A Course in Miracles, which is Jesus too. Thanks to them and others, the overall collective effort, there are other, many, many others too. That's, you know, they helped me see there's a way to evaporate the continuity fear instead of just trying to deny it. Because denying it only works, it's like a shot or a cortisone shot or something. You know, and the pain comes back, and then take another one, and it lasts not as long, and the pain comes back, and then, but then you're deteriorated, and you can't have another one, and then you're really in trouble. So cortisone shots, like a temporary measure. The medicines, all this, like cortisone shots, it's just it's like getting drunk and thinking that your problems have disappeared. Doesn't work. It gets worse. Makes it worse. So all that anybody's doing in this world is just making their situation worse by pretending victimization. I am the only authority there is. There is no other. I am the only authority there is. Say that. You have to say it. You have to say it. Because the truth, it's the truth. This is how we evaporate our continuity fear. Let the wow rise around this, and it's a very strong wow. I am the only authority there is. There is no other authority. No other authority exists whatsoever. I am the only authority there is. There isn't any other authority. Not even a speck of it. I am the total authority. I am the one total, all-powerful authority. I have total authority without any challenge to it whatsoever. You know, this is how we need to talk to ourselves now to make this shift. You know, I got to get better at it. You know, I wish we get some help from a great teacher, you know, who's really perfect at it. You know, that would be great. I'll keep doing my best. But you know, we need adamancy right now, you know, because we'll all be shrinking away from this. So, you know, are you kidding me? Oh my God, this is difficult. But, you know, they have to keep on insisting on it. They can't play around right now. They got to insist on it. I am the one authority. I am the true authority. I am the true authority. I've always been the true authority. I always will be. There never will be another authority. There never will be another authority. There's no authority but me, and there'll never be another authority. And don't worry about terms I, me, stuff like, we know what we're talking about. We're talking about spiritual authority as opposed to believing in personality authority, which doesn't exist. So we can use any pronoun we want to, it doesn't matter. See, that's legalism. We you know, sometimes it's good to be precise, and other times like this, it doesn't matter. We're just putting all our chips on the table. It doesn't say, I am, just say, I am the only authority there is. There's only one authority. This is very important. What is that? Noise in the dark. There's only one authority. This is, again, Jesus' whole key to help us is there's no compromise. There are no two authorities and a compromise among them. If there's only one authority, how can there be a compromise? Why do we need to compromise? It's ridiculous, isn't it? So, of course, the miracles is designed to help us see this. So we're seeing it. We're saying it. See it and say it. See it and say it. You got to say it. I am the I am the, you know, I am the authority. I am the total authority. I am the complete authority. There is no other. I am perfect authority. There's never been any other, never will be. No other authority is possible. I am the authority. No other authority is possible. I am the authority. Now, those who want heavy density won't say this. They want victimization. Okay? That's the difference. Either you want to believe in victimization or not. Lighter density, you realize there's no victimization. Heavier density is all about victimization. And of course, it's the personality that's demanding victimization, which is only our projection. So we're really demanding it. So don't blame the personality for anything. Call the projection back home. Says, you're not to blame. I'm the authority. You have no authority. You'd have no authority to speak for me whatsoever, personality. I am, and it's entirely me. I am the total authority. There is no other. So victimization, if I experience something, it's because I insist on that, not you, personality. You have no authority to speak for me whatsoever. Say, personality, you have no authority to speak for me whatsoever. I am the one exclusive authority. There is no other. So take the personality off the hook. Call your projections back home. Call our projections back home. That's what we're doing now. And we have to do it, you know? So just keep hammering away at this. There's no other way to do it. Maybe it'll start catching hold at some point. It's a huge step to take. It's a huge step, so I understand this. And it's just a matter of when do you want to do it. And for me, it's now. Because it's you know, the collapse is happening. The collapse into the heavier density is happening right now. And I don't care. I don't need to detail the collapse because it's I'm the sole authority. So I'm not collapsing. It's that simple. It's that cut and dried. There's no real collapse. It's just we're demanding this dance, this game of making it seem that way to heavier density. But there's not any personalities, nothing causing it other than our own insistence upon it. So how is that a real collapse? We can just easily insist not, no collapse. For me, there's no collapse, just the opposite, lighter density. There's no collapse of my authority. My authority is pristine and immaculate. It's always been immaculate. I am the one immaculate authority. There is no other. Okay, I am the true immaculate authority. I am the true immaculate authority. There is no other. I am the true immaculate authority. There is no other. So this is getting real. You know, practicing this way is the right way to practice right now. So it's just a matter of someone being adamant enough to drag others along and say, okay, you know, they say, realize, hey, you know, this is what is required right now. Someone who's so adamant that will stop grousing about it and do it. Because it's a severe shift, isn't it? Out of victimization consciousness, but this is what's required right now. Otherwise, we're going to go heavy into it. I am the one immaculate authority. There's never been another. Never will be another. I am authority without a second. I am the authority. I am the authority. There is no other. I say, I am the authority. There is no other. Say it. I am the authority. There is no other. Say it. I am the authority. There is no other. I am the authority, there is no other. I am the authority, there is no other. I'm not used to rain here, so I'm thinking, you know, what do I need to put? Something's out in the rain. I mean, yeah, actually something is, come to think of it. We've just completely forgotten about, you know, rain. What's that? I mean, the barbecue's out in the open. This is out in the open. This is out in the open. Exercise bike's out in the open. My God, I've got to go, you know, throw the cover on the barbecue. It's raining. We're not used to this. So hopefully this practice, you know, I'm frustrated because I know how to practice, and yet it's difficult to do because you have to be very adamant about it because people are really going to dig their heels in right now. So that's why I'm kind of despondent, you know. Of course, this is me being despondent. You know, people say, oh, wow, I wish I could be that despondent. Yeah, I mean, it is. So take heart, everyone. There is a practice for us, okay? There really is. We just have to be, we have to have some adamancy at the top, insisting on it. And then we can drag our heels, but we'll still be dragged along, which is fine. You know, it's okay to drag your heels. I mean, kind of, you know, that's in par, you know, for the course. You're going to be glum about it and say, ah, I got to do this. Wow, got to say this. I say, I am the one immaculate authority, there is no other. I am the true, perfect authority. I am the true, perfect authority. Say, I am the true, perfect authority. Say, I am the true, perfect authority. Say, I am the true, perfect authority. See, that hits hard. I'm feeling it. You have to be sensitive, very sensitive to how what you're practicing, the results of it. You know, you can just feel this. This buzz, this inner buzz from this. I can say, oh, it's potent. If you're buzzing on caffeine, you can't tell the difference. When you're practicing, you won't be able to tell the difference. So you say, well, I don't know how to practice because I'm not sure what's stronger than, whether, you know, is this stronger than that? Because you feel a fake buzz is the problem. So for me, is no buzz at all unless I practice right. I practice right, there's the buzz, which is good. We like the buzz. You know, people like to be buzzed. They feel the intensity. They think, you know, they use drugs. They think they're on the spiritual path. They're not. They can't differentiate between what works and what doesn't. So here, like I can tell. I can tell the difference. Oh, wow, this is a buzz here. So it means, okay, go along that way. Go along that way. Say this. I am the perfect, I am the flawlessly immaculate one authority. There is no other. No authority. No other authority can possibly exist. I am all authority. It's impossible that any other authority exist. I am complete, total, all authority. I'm all authority everywhere, always. There is no other. I'm all authority, say, I'm all authority everywhere, always, there is no other. Say, I'm all authority everywhere, always, there is no other. I'm all authority everywhere, always. There is no other. I'm perfect, flawless, everywhere, always authority. My authority can never fail. It's perfect. Say, my authority can never fail. It's perfect. Say, my authority can never fail. It's perfect. Say, my authority can never fail. It is perfect. It is always present. It is always perfectly present. My authority is always perfectly present. Say, my authority is always perfectly present. Say, my authority is always perfectly present. Say, my authority is always perfectly present. Nothing ever obscures my authority. It's always perfectly present to me. I'm perfectly aware always of my perfect authority. Nothing, say, nothing can ever obscure my perfect authority. Nothing can ever obscure my perfect authority. Nothing can ever obscure my perfect authority. My perfect authority is always present. Say, my perfect authority is always present. Say, my perfect authority is always present. It's always clear to me. My perfect authority is always clear to me. Say, my perfect authority is always clear to me. Say, my perfect authority is always clear to me. Always has been clear to me. Say, that's all of my perfect authority is always has been clear to me and always will be clear to me. My perfect authority has always been clear to me and always will be clear to me. Say, my perfect authority has always been clear to me and always will be clear to me. Perfectly present, perfectly revealed, perfectly present, perfectly revealed, perfectly functional. My perfect authority is always perfectly functional. Say that. My perfect authority is always perfectly functional. Say, my perfect authority is always perfectly functional. Say, my perfect authority is always perfectly functional. Say that. Say, my perfect authority is always perfectly functional and always will be perfectly functional. My perfect authority can never be diminished in any way. Say, my perfect authority can never be diminished in any way. Say, my perfect authority can never be diminished in any way. Say, my perfect authority can never be diminished in any way. My perfect authority can never be diminished in any way. My perfect authority can never be diminished in any way. Be very adamant about it. My perfect authority has never been diminished and will never be diminished. Say, my perfect authority can never be diminished in any way. It has never been diminished and never will be diminished in any way. This is fact. So, channel your upset into practice, which is what I'm doing now. Get very adamant, you know, practice here. Don't let anyone lie to us about our perfect authority. Don't accept any lie. Nothing can touch my perfect authority. Say, nothing can touch my perfect authority. Say, nothing can ever touch my perfect authority anywhere, anytime, anywhere, any place, in no way. Nothing can ever touch my perfect authority. Never, nothing can ever touch my perfect authority. Not even faintly. Not even faintly, not even the faintly. Nothing can ever touch my perfect authority, not even faintly. Not even with a trace. It's my perfect authority is absolutely traceless. There's no trace going to be left upon it. Nothing can touch it. Nothing can leave a trace upon it. There is no residue. My perfect authority creates no residue. My perfect authority creates no trace. Say, my perfect authority creates no residue. My perfect authority creates no residue. My perfect authority, say it, my perfect authority creates no residue. Say, my perfect authority creates no residue. Say, my perfect authority creates no trace. My perfect authority creates no trace. My perfect authority creates no trace. It's all here now. My perfect authority is all here now. Say, my perfect authority is all here now. Say, my perfect authority is all here now. Say, my perfect authority is all here now. There's no trace of it. It's all here now. It's whole. It's complete. It's all here now. Absolutely, totally all here right now. It's all here right now. I am the one authority. Say, I am the one authority. I am the one true authority. I am the one true authority. Say, I am the one true authority. Say it. I am the one true authority. Say it. I am the one true authority. There is no other. See, the personality can't exist unless there's belief in two authorities. So when we assert there's only one authority, that means we're calling out the projection of our personality back home. That's exactly what it means. So it doesn't matter if you say I. You know, people say, oh, non-dualists will say, oh, you can't say the I, there is no I. This is nonsense. We're asserting there is no two wills. There's only one authority. And that automatically means that there is no personality. That's only a projection, and that we are truth. Automatically. Belief in the personality automatically is the assumption of two wills, two authorities. So when we say there aren't two authorities, only one, we are calling the projection back home. Guaranteed. So we're going to non-dual. I mean, asserting there's only one authority is asserting I'm non-dual. But it's okay to say I am non-dual. It's okay. I am non-dual. Spirit is non-dual. We can say me. I am identity. I am non-dual. I am the one authority. That's it. There is no other. So we don't need to get hung up on these non-dual games, you know, the rhetoric. I mean, there's a place for that. In certain practices, there's a place for it, which is fine. But in this practice, you know, this shift, doesn't matter. It's only important to assert there's only one authority. There's none other whatsoever. So whatever is the true one authority, I am that. The one true authority, I am that. I have to be. Since there's only one authority and I exist, you know, how can I not be that? I have to be that. There's only one true authority and I am that. There's one true authority and I am that. Say, there's only one true authority and I am that. There's only one true authority and I am that. Say, there's only one true authority, and I am that. I had to come home and rest. This felt so terrible. Sudden depression grabbed me, but that was because I couldn't practice. I said, I need to practice, and I can't do it. What's the matter? I gotta practice. Well, the practicing has to be very adamant like this, and there's just no role models for that, really. There are no role models. Not really. Not here now. And you know, I can't find them. I just said, wow, I gotta do this myself? Holy cow. There's only one authority, and I am that. So I was protesting, you know, like, why do I have to do it? Come on. I mean, it's ridiculous. Me? There's got to be, you know, a million better teachers than me, a million better examples. Come on. Where are they? I can't hang around waiting for them. I don't see them. I can't find them. So there's only one authority, and I am that. There's only one true authority, and I am that. There's only one authority, and I am that. There's only one real, true authority, and I am that. There is no other authority. It doesn't exist. Fantasy authority is not authority. Fantasies have no authority. A fantasy authority has no authority. There's only one authority, and I am that. Say, there's only one authority, and I am that. Okay, so at least we're getting the gist of this here, but it needs to be rolled out stronger and stronger and stronger. I don't know how that's possible in this world to practice directly with people like this, you know, I don't know, but it takes a teacher who's absolutely certain, you know, just who can be adamant about it. So we'll keep trying here. Again, I'm not going to wait around for someone to show up. We've hoped someone would show up for a long time. They haven't, so You know, just we have to then push it out ourselves, do the best we can. So that's what we're doing. So we're trying. And if someone shows up, hey, more the merrier. Great. Thanks for showing up. But certainly, they cannot practice less than this. They must say, I am the one true authority. There is no other. I am that. There's one true authority, and I am that. I am the one true authority. I am that. There is no other. They would certainly embrace this. They would certainly say, wonderful, you know. They wouldn't say, oh, no, well, you know. No, it's a great, great, great practice. Great practice. There's no question it's a great practice. So, you know, we put them on the hot spot. Anyone shows up, put them on the, let's challenge them. Put them on the hot seat. Absolutely. Let's hear your practice. What do you recommend? Now, if they just want to be silent, that's good too. But we also need practice. The silence could inspire our practicing, sure. That works that way too. Someone shows up like Ron Maharshi, perfect silence, well, that would inspire our practicing. We'd be very much more adamant about it. Nisargadatta Maharaj, as Guru, just said, hey, just say I am. Just a feeling, I am, I am. Say I am, feel I am. There is no other, I am. I am that, there is no other. I am, there is no other. This is a profound practice too. I am, there is no other. I am, there is no other. And so he just did it. The guru inspired him. The guru didn't have to say anything else. I didn't even go see him again, really. Hardly. I don't think. Maybe once, or maybe not even at all. I don't know. It was just like, he said, okay, I'll do it. And he just did it. I am. I am. There is no other. I am. And it didn't take him long, you know, before he was enlightened. So someone inspired him to practice correctly. He was ready. He was ready. We could use someone like Nisargadatta Maharaj for sure in the world. Very feisty, very adamant. Unapologetic about it. That kind of spirit, you know, feisty. That's what we that would be very helpful. Silence would be helpful too. You know, a lot of different ways it can be helpful, but, you know, we need him now. You know, not later. Now. I am now. I am now. I am. That's like the most abbreviated type of practice possible. Just I am. I am. I am. Meaning there is no other. I am and there is no other. I am and there is no other. I am the sole authority. There is no other. I am and there is no other. I am and I am that. I am and I am that. I am that I am. I am that I am. Again, a very condensed practice. I am that I am. There is no other. I am the totality of I am. There is no other. I am the absolute totality of I am. And that I am, and there is no other. Say that. Keep saying it. Keep saying it. Try to say it. It gets easier as you know, you have to break through. And I did one time, and I did another video. I did a little bit of it. Doing more now. I mean, this is easing into it. You know, this is what's needed. It's tough. The first couple of steps is difficult. Jesus always says the first few steps are the only ones that are really difficult. Once you take a few first few steps, it becomes easy. You know, he's right. He's right. And I think this is what everyone's having trouble with right now is those first few steps. So we'll keep working at it. You know, keep working at it. But don't procrastinate too long, because the world is collapsing into heavier density right now. And claiming this as some great victory, some spiritual victory, you know. Freedom, liberation. It's Orwellian. It's just temporary dulling the continuity if you're temporarily stunning it, because it's like saying, we can hardly believe we're so stupid, you know. Like, oh my gosh, maybe total stupidity will work. You know, we have this temporary kind of think like, well, maybe we're getting a reprieve. We're being really stupid here. maybe God can be fooled. And then later on, we start getting buyer's remorse, saying, "Oh, this is horrible. Here, help, 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 get me out of this." And this is this whole thing just keeps playing out that way. So, first couple of steps are the most difficult. You have to take them. We all do. And that's what I'm struggling with right now, trying to do it, and getting it done here, you know, step by step. And the wow is very intense from this practice now. Very, very intense. So I'll probably need to, it's time to say, okay, that's enough. I don't want to push it too hard here. I think people, I know it gets shaky and trembly, and you feel the intensity of it. I know I've been feeling the intensity of it, so I understand it's very intense. And just, you know, you just keep easing into it and keep trying and do a little bit, little bit, little bit, little bit, do a little more, and full stop in the wow, and just say, okay, I got to gut it out right now. Because the alternative is terrible. So, you know, we can gut it out a little bit. Keep your discipline. It's very important. Keep the discipline. I don't know if I'll watch the ninth inning of the World Series or not, or whatever it is. It's probably over by now. It's 5:15, 6:15, 7:15. It's almost 8. That's 2 hours and 45 minutes. It's probably over. Missed the World Series. Okay, well, great. Because we did something immeasurably better here as we took another big step towards this profound practice where we're getting close to just I am. I am. I am, I am, and that goes into enlightenment. Absolutely, it does. Absolutely, it does. I am, there is no other. 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 This is just calling the personality back home and saying, that's only a projection. There's no truth, reality. I projected it. There is no self there. There is no I there. There is no identity there. There's no will there. It doesn't exist. I'm admitting it. I'm saying it. It was all my projection. I am. There is no other. This is how we do it. Okay. Very great. That's it for this one. And we will keep on trucking here. Fast. Fast, fast, fast. Okay. Hope the evening of the 27th is great. This is, I believe it's the evening of the 27th when I've had great success. And, well, this is happening right now. Historically, it's happened this way for me. So it is happening. We're practicing in an adamant way now. Gotten to I am. Just straight out I am. Fantastic. Very great. That's it.